we are in one of my clients' YouTube channels, and I wanted to test this thumbnail feature on her, give y'all kind of like a behind the scenes look of everything. What you'll see here is like this video is about IVF and whether or not it is safe for women after the age of 40. I want to go down here to thumbnail, right? So I already uploaded the video. On this upload section here, you'll see thumbnail, and then you'll see the test and compare option. And so I want to test out a few options for thumbnails. And so to give you an idea of what they're going to be, is I have one thumbnail that has a text like too late for IVF. I have another one that said that says like too old for IVF. And then Whitney's here with this little with a different facial expression. And then I have one that says too late for IVF with Whitney's face being that way. And so I have three options that I want to test out. And let's go ahead and add those in here now. And so test and compare different thumbnails, upload up to three images. Perfect. And then the thing that makes that stands out to me is like, okay, we want to wait for the results up to 2 weeks to see the report. Let's go ahead and start uploading these thumbnails. All right. And we're going to press the done. So now I went ahead and uploaded it here. And right now it says that it's ineligible because the video is not public yet, right? Which is totally fine. When I am ready to actually schedule this, I'm going to come back and we're going to see what happens next. Okay, so everything is optimized now. I have the three thumbnails that are right here. So right now it says that it's ineligible because the video is not public. So I'm thinking that when I schedule it, which is what I'm going to do, it should be okay. It's now scheduled. Yeah, we're just going to see if when it becomes live on Monday, if this becomes eligible. And now we are checking back in to see if this is actually running. It is. This video is live as of like an hour ago. It looks here that the test and compare is running. Thank goodness. I was a little bit afraid that it wasn't going to run for some reason. But this is why I wanted to do this like in the moment video with y'all, to kind of show y'all what happens through the process, or what I kind of the things that I think about how I'm going to be using this feature. So now we just wait. And so the next question is, well, how long is this going to take? So some of this documentation is saying that the winning results may take a few days up to 2 weeks to be finalized. When the results are ready, they'll be available in YouTube Studio, and then you'll be able to choose the winning thumbnail or rerun the new test. And so they're using the watch time as the main metric to determine which thumbnail is the winner. And so I'm going to be checking this and seeing how long it will take for them to choose a winner. Stay tuned. I wanted to go ahead and show another example of using the test and compare thumbnail feature, because now I'm getting ready to upload one of my videos. And so this video is all about how to move your YouTube channel to a brand account. The thumbnails that I am going to be testing is going to be one of me like looking at the arrow with personal account, arrow over to brand account, moving my head, looking over here. And then the main one that I wanted to test out was without me in it, which is the personal account to brand account image here. So we're gonna try these three out. Let's see what happens. So we're gonna do the same process right here. Insert thumbnail, test and compare. And let's upload these three images here. All right, let's go ahead and press done. And I'm actually going to schedule this to go live on Monday. So I'll come back and let you know when things are good to go. And so while we wait for this one, let's go ahead and take a look at what some of the findings are for Whitney's video. Here we are in Whitney's video that we did the test and compare in. As you can see, it's still running, but you can go in here at options and it looks like you can go ahead and view the test report even while it's still running, just kind of see where things are heading. Right now it says that estimated time running is 10 days and 19 hours left. So as we said before, it will run on a maximum of 2 weeks, which is fine. Right now it seems like this one, the too old for IVF one, with Whitney like looking a little like, I don't even know how to explain it, but you know what I'm trying to say, is having like slightly the highest
So let's see what else happens. Because this is only after like I think about 200 views this video has right now. So let's see what happens in a few more days.
Okay, so now we are back. Whitney's test has been complete, and I wanted to show you something interesting, right? So this A/B test doesn't have a 100% clear winner, but YouTube has determined a preferred thumbnail, which was number two, right? Which the watch time share, it got about 40% of the watch time share here. What does it mean when something is preferred, right? And so if you look right here, it says that the thumbnail likely outperformed other thumbnails based on watch time share, okay? Preferred thumbnail may be more engaging to viewers, but they can't really determine with a high level of clarity. This is most likely because it probably needed some more impressions. It probably needed some more views, right? So I believe this video, Whitney has a small channel, and this is probably like a very niche topic, but it's really interesting to kind of see what happens with even just A/B testing like this small group. Now, I have been seeing some other YouTube videos about like larger channels doing the test and compare and how they have seen like these areas of improvement, so to speak, with test and compare. But they had mentioned that it is more helpful when you have about over, like, I want to say that it was about 2,000 views that would help them like really understand what's really happening for the thumbnail A/B test. So this is just one example of how this whole thing went, right? And so really, like, the more impressions and the more views your video gets, the more data that YouTube has in order for it to determine which thumbnail really did the best. But you can see here that we could run a whole new test with all different thumbnails, right? And then we could try this again. And so this feature is available for you in your own YouTube studio right now, and you can run as many tests as you want. I'm going to get into some of my final thoughts, or like what you can do to benefit like the most from this A/B test, this test and compare report in a second. Let's go and see how my YouTube video did as well. So now we're into my thumbnail A/B testing account, and something really interesting happened. So let's go in, and I want to show you. So my test did not have a conclusive result. A few things could be the reason, right? So a few things could be because the thumbnails weren't that different, or it just didn't have enough impressions for it to get, enough results. Well, I'm not receiving a winner result, right? Minimal difference in thumbnails or not enough impressions, right? And so we would need to get more impressions in order for it to happen. So is the test and compare feature really like worth it for small channels? I also did another video that I did the test and compare on. So let's go back here. And again, right, this test didn't have conclusive results, right? And it ran for that period of time, and it doesn't have it isn't showing any data, any watch time share. You can set your own thumbnail if you wanted to. Like, I could probably set this one. I probably would do that. Let's see if I'll set it to thumbnail three. This is very interesting, right? Because you need more impressions in order for test and compare to have enough information to know whether or not whatever thumbnail is the right one. Is it worth it to pay your editor or your graphic designer more money to create three additional thumbnails if you're not even getting the data with test and compare? I think for small channels, it's probably not worth it. Like, right, I'm testing it out. I don't think that it's that worth it because you're not getting as much impressions as maybe like other larger channels. Is A/B testing like not good for your channel in general? Well, no, it is. But maybe it's worth you doing it manually. Maybe don't put all your eggs in the test and compare feature. Maybe over time, if you're not getting the click-through rate and the watch time that you want, maybe changing the thumbnail is the best course of action, right? Because yes, like A/B testing thumbnails and titles are going to help you overall. Is that the thing that should compel you to do A/B testing now? Is it going to make A/B testing easier for you? And if you're a small channel, probably not. I'm actually going to link the video that I was watching about test and compare because this larger channel, I think they're called Channel Makers, and they did so many A-B tests for thumbnails that are like completely the same. It was giving them so many different data. And so they actually were able to meet with you to kind of get an understanding of the direction that they're going. And in that video, the YouTube spokesperson mentioned that maybe Test and Compare should have been rolled out to people who were in the YouTube partner program because they're already getting a certain amount of views, already getting a certain amount of impressions to give the A-B testing like system enough information to like run efficiently. A-B testing is still important to me, but I may just be doing it manually for now on and just like seeing what's going on. Now, there is another tool that you could use for A-B testing. That tool is with TubeBuddy. One second. Let me look into that real quick. TubeBuddy is another keyword research tool, YouTube, Chrome extension, similar to vidIQ. They actually allow you to do A-B testing. So looking at this feature here, you're able to optimize your video thumbnails and metadata to increase your click-through rates, right? And so with TubeBuddy, they're using the click-through rate as the metric to determine whether or not the YouTube video, if the thumbnail is working, which makes sense to me. And you can test thumbnails, titles, tags, and more with all of like your videos. So TubeBuddy is really great if you really want to get into like the data behind things. VidIQ is really good for like starting out, but if you want to get into like the more like bulk tool, like bulk creation, like really, or getting into the analytics side of things, TubeBuddy is so great for that. Let me know if you want me to do a test with TubeBuddy instead and see what happens with that. That'd be really cool. And I already have like a lifetime license. I probably just need to upgrade it probably to get access to the A-B test feature. So I may end up doing a video on that. This video was just made just to show y'all how I'm using it and if I should use it and if I'm thinking about using the Test and Compare feature right now, because for business owners, our channels are smaller, but we're like getting clients with it still. And so we don't put that much focus on getting a bunch of views, getting a bunch of impressions. We're thinking about getting like the right views and the right impressions. Now, more is better. You know what I'm saying? I'm not mad at that. But seeing as so the Test and Compare feature is really beneficial for people that have larger followings or larger, that have a larger channel, it may not be that beneficial right now for smaller channels or for smaller business owners looking to like use YouTube for business, because we're not trying to like grow it at this exponential rate right now. Maybe TubeBuddy's A-B testing feature will work better. See you in the next video. Bye.